Hello dear students and viewers, welcome back with veterinary entomology lectures. In this video lecture, I'm gonna discuss briefly about the Tabanus fly or Tabanids under the suborder Brachycera. First, I will discuss the morphological features of Tabanid flies. Then, I will summarize the morphological differentiation among different genera of Tabanid flies. As these flies act as both biological and mechanical vector, it is important to know their mouthpart and feeding mechanism. Tabanid flies are more efficient mechanical vector in comparison to other flies. I will explain the reason as well. Finally, I will discuss the life cycle of Tabanid flies and medical and veterinary importance of these flies. If you like this video, put your comments or feedback in the comment section below. Your feedback will be highly appreciated. If you want to get more video lecture on veterinary entomology, don't forget to subscribe the channel. So let's get started. You know, we study different arthropods under the suborder Nematocera, Brachycera, and Cyclohepa. Under this suborder, Tabanidae is an important family. Flies under this family is called Tabanids. They are popularly known as breeze fly or clegs or horsefly. So under this Tabanidae family, there are four subfamilies such as Pangonini, Chrysopsini, Tabanini, and Sepsidini. The important genus or genera include Pangonia, Chrysops, Tabanus, Hematopota. I'll discuss about these four genera in this lecture. Morphological features of Tabanids or Tabanus flies. Tabanids are the largest flies, having very stout body, head is larger, bean shaped, and broader than long. They have very well developed eyes. Eyes are comparatively wider in Hematopota, and in live specimen, brilliantly colored color pattern can be seen. Unicolor horizontal band is seen in Tabanus species, zigzag band for Hematopota, and eyes are spotted in Chrysops species. Remember that this eye color disappear after death. Male and female can also be differentiated based on their eyes. You know, for male, eyes is holoptic, that is, in both eyes are closely located. For female, it is dicoptic, that is, both eyes are distantly located, or you can say there is more gap between two eyes. Antenna is porect, that is, it is directed forward. You know, there are three types of antenna for different arthropods. For Tabanid fly, antenna is stylet type. It has three segments. The first segment is called scape. The second segment is called pedicel. The third segment known as flagellum. This flagellum has several segments. Depending on the number of segments in the flagellum, different genera of Tabanid flies can be identified. For an example, Pangonia has 7 or 8 segments, whereas Tabanus has 5 segments in flagellum of their antenna. This is a typical leg of an insect, showing the different parts of it. Tibia may bear a spur, which also helps in the differentiation of different genera of Tabanid flies. Legs bears 3 pairs, 2 palvillae and 1 empodium at the end of the leg, which helps to prevent bumping during landing or sitting on the host body. Wings of Tabanid flies. Each wing is 6 to 30 millimeter in length and has well developed wing venation. Almost similar wing venation is observed in each genus, therefore it is not possible to differentiate the genera based on wing venation. You can see the discal cell, which is hexagonal in shape in all the genera, and it is located more or less in the center of the wing. Radial vein 4 and radial vein 5 straddling to the apex in all the genera. Other than these common characteristics, the wings of Pangonia has a clear or dusky band, and there is a dark costal region and dark band present in the wings of Chrysops. The wings of Tabanus has either clear or dusky band. Mottled wing is the feature of the genus Hematopota. Morphological differentiation of different genera of Tabanid flies. Based on this criteria, one can easily differentiate different genera of Tabanid flies. Ocelli are well developed in Pangonia and Chrysops, whereas in Tabanus and Hematopota, ocelli are vestigial. Among these four genera, proboscis is longer than head only for Pangonia. As mentioned earlier, segments of flagellum of antenna has helped in morphological differentiation of different genera of Tabanid flies. So in Pangonia, 7 or 8 segments are there. In Chrysops and Tabanus, 5 segments of flagellum is there. Hematopota has only 4 segments in their flagellum. Spar on the leg is larger in case of Pangonia. In Chrysops and Tabanus, spar is smaller. In Hematopota, there is no spar on the leg. Remember that spar is located usually behind the tibia of each leg. And wings, dark band is present in Chrysops, and mottled wing is seen in Hematopota. Here you can see adult Pangonia, Chrysops, Tabanus, and Hematopota. In Pangonia, as mentioned earlier, proboscis is longer and wing is clear. In Chrysops, dark band is seen on the wings. Wing is clear in Tabanus, and color pattern, that is mottled wing, is seen in Hematopota. So this is the summary of everything that I have already discussed. You know, the mouth parts of Nematoceran flies are piercing and sucking type, whereas the members of Cyclohepa possess sponging or lapping type of mouth parts. That is, Cyclohepa can't pierce the host skin, they can only absorb the ready-made fluid or blood. The mouth part of Tabanid flies combine blood-sucking mouth part of Nematoceran with the lapping or sponging mouth part of Cyclohepa. That is, the mouth parts of Brachycera or Tabanid flies can rupture or lacerate the host skin, then sponge the blood. The paired maxillae are narrow and the paired mandible are broad, saw-like structure. Food or vesicle can be formed by combining the stout labrum and a narrow hypopharynx with maxillae and mandibles. Vesicles sit together in the labial gutter located anterior side of the labium. Stout-bodied labium bears terminally a pair of large, fleshy, inflatable labella. When the Tabanid flies feeds, the labella are retracted to expose the vesicle, which pierce and lacerate the tissue for full feeding. The cutting function is done by mandible and maxilla. When the feeding ceases, the fascicle is withdrawn and the lamella come together to trap the blood film. In the lamella, the pathogen can survive for a while. In the meantime, if the fly feed on other animals, they can transmit the infection. This is actually a mechanical type of disease transmission. Research shows that Trypanosoma evansi can survive in lamella for an hour. In case of biological transmission, pathogen passes with the saliva during feeding on a host. So this is all about mouthparts of Tabanid flies and their feeding mechanism. Why Tabanid flies are the most efficient mechanical vector in comparison to other flies? In order to understand this, you have to first understand the mouthparts and feeding of Nematocera, Brachycera, and Cyclohepa. The mouthpart of Nematocera is piercing and sucking type. The mouthpart of Brachycera is slashing and sponging type. That is, the members of this suborder can lacerate the host tissue and can sponge the blood. The members of Cyclohepa can't lacerate or penetrate the host skin, rather only sponge the ready-made fluid or blood. So in the mouth part of Nematocera, pathogen can't survive. In the level of this two, pathogen can survive for a while. As the mouth part of Tabanid flies have both lacerating and sponging features, that is, they can first acquire the infectious agent and can pass it to the host, which make them more efficient mechanical vector in comparison to the members of Nematocera and Cyclohepa. Life cycle of a Tabanid fly. Male and female flies feed on nectars and mating occurs. It is noted that female flies need blood milk to produce eggs. A Tabanid fly lay around 100 to 800 eggs. Many species lay eggs on the backside of the leaves of trees. Each egg hatches within 2 to 3 days, and larval stage 1 drops from the leaf. There are around 6 to 13 larval estuaries in the life cycle of a Tabanid fly. Pupa developed within 1 to 3 weeks, and the type of pupa is optic, that is, the appendages such as wings and legs are bound to the body by molting fluid and can be seen externally. Tabanid flies can act as both biological and mechanical vectors for different nematodes such as Loa loa, Iliophora, Dirofilaria romeri, and for protozoa like Hemoproteus mysticosi, Trypanosoma thaleri, they act as biological vector. You have to memorize this list for your exams. For different types of viral disease, bacterial or protozoal and rickettsial diseases, Tabanid flies can act as efficient mechanical vector. So these are the reference material that I have taken to prepare this presentation. If you want to get more video lecture on veterinary parasitology, including veterinary entomology, don't forget to subscribe the channel. Thank you for watching this video, and good luck for your studies.